Yes, I'm boxing, nigga. Don't like, don't comment, don't subscribe. You getting right here, man. Getting a mean ass right hook, nigga. Let's get it, nigga.
This can show you the levels to the combat sport of boxing. You got somebody out on the street that don't know nothing about boxing and go on the beach and say, I can do it, and end up with one of these guys and get seriously hurt.
Man, nervous right now, bruh. So today, I'm at this boxing gym, about to take some body shots with,
hey, yo.
Take some body hits by some professional boxers. Coach Bobby, the Henry brothers, they're gonna be here today with some other professional boxers, and they're gonna endorse some pain on me, hitting me in the body like that. And I ain't gonna lie, I'm nervous as shit right now. But remember, y'all boys, eat your vitamins, stay in school, and most importantly, don't subscribe to my channel. Let's get it.
Trick or treat. Why? Cause I ain't bought a beans.
In order to get anywhere in here, you gotta have a 3-minute mentality.
3 minute?
3 minute mentality. With boxing, you gotta have a 3-minute mentality because everything you do gotta be 3 minutes. When they practice, every round is 3 minutes. Think about it. First amateur fight is 3 minutes, three rounds. I wouldn't teach you just to do 3 rounds. I want you to do 6 rounds when you're working out, 9 rounds when you're working out. So when you're going to fight, that 3 rounds ain't nothing. In order to get that accomplished, there's workout before the actual gloves come on in boxing. And that consists of the rope jumping, the shadow boxing, and some other pre-workout stretching. So we're gonna put P on some jump rope. Come over here.
I bet.
Little jump.
Not so high.
You ain't gotta jump so high. Just little bumps.
Bumps. There you go, little bumps. You see that I'm good enough. Turn it up, get them hands up. Slow down, slow down. There you go.
There we go. Keep your hands up. Hands up. Like that boy
is a cap. You gotta skip with it, man. Come on. There you go.
One, two.
There you go. There you go. If you don't speak, does that mean we're through?
Don't like sleep that you do. I ain't hard yet.
Yeah. But what was that?
Y'all gotta run it. Come on, baby, take it off. They gonna get your ass, you walk around here with this little turn around.
I ain't gonna lie, Coach Bobby, this shit is not
so- You gotta knock the f*** out! Yeah, that's what this does. But I guarantee you, you're able to go rounds. You're able to compete. You're not tired after those 3 rounds because you do this every day. Ain't nothing down now. I make everybody who's been down, who got their hands on their hips, who got all that, make them give me 10 push-ups. We're not gonna do that now. You're not in class. You ain't paying me for this, so we ain't gonna go through that yet.
People just think that they come to the gym, put their bag down, put on their gloves, and jump in the ring and hit somebody. It's not like that at all. This is not no sport that you just play. You can hurt yourself in this.
Stop bullshitting, Bryce. Throw like you mean it too, nigga.
The first day of boxing, I wanted to quit this shit.
Don't subscribe to my channel. Let's get it.
For you, I wanted you to understand the significance of what boxing consists of, not just something that you think that it's all gravy. Like, if you get in this and you give me 150%, I'm gonna give you 180%. I'm gonna give you 200%. That's how I work. Because like I said, I didn't have that support. I'm gonna make sure my kids have that undivided support when they do anything.
One thing about boxing, this shit year round. And this is not no sport that you just play. You can hurt yourself in this.
You are not the guy!
In this sport, you can play football, you can play basketball. Hell, you can even play hockey. But you cannot, and I repeat, you cannot play boxing. You'll be hurt or dead. Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Perfect. I am Bobby R. Henry Jr., father of Bryce Henry and Bobby Henry III. He don't like to be called Bobby, he likes to be called Trey, so famous duo, boxing brothers here out in South Florida. Where does this all start? Well, it all started with me. And in order to know them, you got to know from where I come from.
Police experts say youth gangs have all of Dade County covered, from the Young Latin Organization in North Miami Beach to the Hialeah Boys in Hialeah, La Familia, the Latin Force, and the Latin Disciples in Southwest Dade, to the 56th Avenue Bad Boys and the 34th Street Players in Miami.
I'm from, as I said before, Kara City, Miami. I did a lot of fighting growing up. I never forget, I got in one fight where I broke my finger. I broke this knuckle right here. This part I broke completely off. Knocked a dude back 2 feet. Once it established that I had good handwork, everybody, you know, pretty much stayed away from me.
Growing up in Miami at that age, 17, my started putting down their fists, started picking up guns. So I seen a lot of homeboys and friends, you know what I'm saying?
That was going down the wrong road, you know what I'm saying? Homeboys that got shot, homeboys that got died, homeboys that killed themselves. I saw all type of crazy stuff, and I'm only 16, 17 years old.
So, you know, I was in a household where I never had nobody to, like, you know what I'm saying, that could support what I wanted to do. I had to, like, help everybody else. That's what it came. Like, they got in a fight, I had to go fight for them, you know what I'm saying, stuff like that. That's how I did, but I said I wouldn't let my kids grow up like that, you feel me?
I don't know why I got freaking butterflies in my stomach, bro. I gotta shake that shit out, bro. Let's go. What's your opinion on spring break boxing?
Spring break boxing?
Yeah, how you feel about that?
I ain't cap, that shit dumb as I don't know who the fuck. I mean, it seemed fun and all, and like all that shit.
I think I just seen that little kid go viral.
Like, bro, niggas really get like fucked up out there.
Oh, fuck that!
Took off.
It scared the shit out of you.
Wait, I was running, yes. I was terrified. I was terrified.
There you go. Swing them hands.
I'm not even do this shit, dog.
Man, get up. Ain't nothing down there. That's push-up area. Speed bag. Everybody think this that? No. This is about listening, keep your hands and eyes up. You don't want to hit it here, you don't want to hit it there. You want to hit it like that. Pay attention now. It's a mental thing. I'm doing this for a reason. Let's go. Slow down. Where I told you to hit it at?
The T.
Where's the T at? How you hit the T? I mean, you got to come down with it. Yes. Slow down. Eye hand coordination. You're definitely not gonna do that. That's just how I'm hitting it.
You.
What you doing? No.
Take a deep breath. Let it out. Take a deep breath. Let it out. Focus on this right here. This is nothing. It's not a test. Just focus on this. Focus on that back knuckle hitting that teeth. Simple as that.
This ain't no joke. That's why it's called a speed bag. This teaches people to keep their hands up, and it gives you hand-eye coordination. What I lacked as a kid mentally, as far as like support, and just having somebody there, I did not have that. So
I was always like the big brother to people. Like, they always had me. Bobby is the Einstein of boxing. He's actually one of the best teachers I know in boxing. Like, he surpassed me. And it's so crazy that how raw he is, you know what I mean? As far as his mental IQ of boxing is.
Shoot it! But you got a rhythm to it, and you keep it going. Shoot it! Shoot it! Turn your body. Shoot it! Stop bullshitting, Bryce. Throw like you mean it too, man. See, you're not turning, nigga. Turn, bro. Shoot it. Shoot it.
What he loves to do is train people, and he loves photography, fishing, boxing over everything.
Day three, bro. Deep today. Let's see what Coach Bobby got me doing today. Right now, I'm just chilling, watching them train and get their little workout in right now. And yeah, let's do it.
Oh, hold up, doing these right here, dog, you gotta learn how to get that big girl up off you, you feel me?
Big girl off you?
That get that big girl up off you.
You got experience, bro?
We're not really with big girls. You gotta just pull straight up. So,
try that shit.
Hold it,
yeah.
And back down. Just like that. Just like that, and just pull. Ah, hold it. 5 seconds, one. Two, he about to die, y'all. Three,
chilling,
four,
chilling,
five,
chilling.
Back down.
I'm chilling.
I'm totally secure, and no matter what Bobby places himself in, the outcome is gonna be 100% good.
155 pounders for you now. Our Davis versus Trevor Morris. Howard Davis enters 2-1-1 promotionally in BKFC, 3-1-1 overall in the sport of bare knuckle fighting. Davis
fighting out of Broward County, Florida, Howard H.D. Davis.
Stiff jab from Davis from range. Jab from Trevor Morris. Left hand from Davis.
For your winner by TKO, Howard H.D. Davis.
This was his pro combat sports debut, and Howard Davis continues to roll in BKFC. He is most definitely a fighter to watch at 155 pounds. The winner by way of fourth round TKO due to corner stoppage, Howard Davis defeats.
Bryce, I think he Rambo or somebody, you know what I mean? He loves guns and knives and stuff of that nature. Bryce is the chicken wing guy. I can remember wherever we went, any restaurant we went to, I don't give a damn, we went to Red Lobster, we went to Papa Do's Seafood. If we went to Subway, this boy would ask me, y'all got some chicken wings or chicken tenders, because that's all he liked.
Show how it's done, dude. Show how it's done.
Miss, I scared the shit out of him earlier, boy.
Bitch, don't hear me.
Come on, just go.
Howard.
Hey, knock it out, though, Bryce. Hey, stop watching. Oh, shit. Nigga, hey, touch that shit, bro. But touch that shit, bro. Touch that shit. I want you to touch that shit. Nigga, get down, nigga. Oh, shit.
Alright,
nigga,
I'm not gonna shit.
And hamburgers, you know what I mean? That's one thing about him, he's always been stuck in his way. He like what he like.
How long you been boxing? Why you got into boxing?
I'm gonna let y'all do the math, man.
I've been boxing for like 12 years.
I was boxing since I was 9.
I was 10 years old. My younger brother, Bobby, he always wanted to do boxing. Like, he didn't really like mess around with the football and like basketball, like the team sport.
I was a victim of like bullying and stuff like that. And I mean, but I want to protect myself and stuff like that.
Bobby turned 10.
Nigga turned 9 or something like that.
One of them, it was one of their birthdays.
And Bobby was like, Daddy, can we go try the boxing? Luckily that they got a cousin by the name of Antonio Bang Williams. Big shout out to Bang. His stepfather had a gym called Bang Boxing. So I took him. I snuck him to the gym.
They just left me one day. So I'm at the house looking stupid as
I didn't take Bryce.
So boom, they came back. I said, damn, where y'all went? He said, well, we went to the boxing gym.
People don't know this, that Bobby was boxing first.
You a motherfucker. But basically, my little brother got me into it. At first, I ain't really mess with it, because the first day of boxing, I wanted to quit this shit. So I really followed my younger brother. Like, I ain't have no business boxing. I didn't want to box. I just did it because he did it.
Boxing, when he got in there? He loved it. I guess he loved the fact he could beat up somebody. He had to, you know, Gemini. He had to release that anger. So I took Bobby. So Bobby came home telling Bryce, you know what I'm saying, what it was. So Bryce came to me. I go to practice with y'all because it's like a week or two in. So I'm like, all right, come on. But I didn't say anything. I just let him go because they was chilling with Bang. You know, they wasn't really into it yet. So Bryce started joining Bobby. They was going to practice now. They came to me and they was like, Daddy, can we sign up? We want to sign up. We want to go tournaments. We want to box, all this. I'm like, I'm not going to be able to do that. Because one thing, this is not no sport that you just play. You can hurt yourself in this. So I tell y'all what, if y'all really want to do this, you give me a year, just one whole year of y'all just training. And if y'all do this for a year, I'll sign y'all up.
Point. Damn, nigga! What's good with you?
Turn him, JoJo.
I don't be on the court like that, but you know, back in middle school, you look in middle school. Middle school, in high school, I'll fuck you up. But now you got that. I don't play ball like that no more.
Gonna follow them glasses up today. Ooh, you getting it. Get it, boy. See, your thing is, what you trying to do, this is what, stand up. Ain't no air down there. Put your hands off your hips. That's 10 push-ups, each thing you just did. It gets real hard. This ain't no bitch. All right? Let's go.
That's 40, bro. Yes. Oh, shit. I thought I got a cramp. I got a cramp.
For you, I wanted you to understand the significance of what boxing consists of, not just something that you think that it's all gravy. Like, people just think that they come to the gym, put their bag down, put on their gloves, and jump in the ring and hit somebody. It's not like that at all. The first thing I teach in boxing is the foundation. That's your foundation. That's your bottom feet, how you hold yourself up. You can't throw no punches or do no movements if you don't have a solid foundation, so I wanted to instruct that in you. You know what I mean? And get you to do the stuff that make your breath, so you can see how the breathing works. That's what I wanted to get you, to show you the real. Fast forward, 364 days of the year, Bobby come to me like, Daddy, tomorrow make a year. You say for a year we can get signed up. Bobby, they had the ability not to just fight in the local shows, but to travel abroad, travel to different states and fight.
Combo! Combo! Bobby first fight. Bobby was Floyd Mayweather. Ooh, Bobby was moving. Couldn't be touched. But Bobby lost the fight. And, you know, as a parent, I'm sitting there like, they're going to raise Bobby's hand, you know, they're going to win. It was like, winner, red corner. Whoa, he ain't touched my son. Like, what's going on here? Dog, he didn't touch, like, Lord is my witness. Somebody recorded it. But that right there let me know what was going on. Like, amateur boxing and pro boxing is two different sports. Amateur boxing wants you to come forward and throw a multitude of punches. Never stop throwing punches. Boxing, pro boxing, is about throwing skilled punches. You know what I mean? You don't waste your time throwing unnecessary punches in pro boxing. So the punches you're throwing pro boxing are punches that are used to hurt. Amateur boxing you're throwing to get points. Like I said, Bobby lost the first fight, and I can remember that so vividly because we both was hurt. I was more hurt for him, you know what I mean? Because he was like, he thought he won, you know what I mean? And like I said, I've never been that parent to be like, oh, they cheated you. I wanted to say it so bad. Well, they cheated, man, they cheated. But, you know, I don't want you to have a false perception of life.
I
Way better. One thing about boxing, this shit year round. Ain't no off season in this. You feel me? Ain't nothing gonna happen one day, in 1 week. It's gonna take time. But I guarantee you, you know a lot more now than when you first started in this.
Oh, hell yeah.
When you was on that beach that day doing that referee shit, you know a lot more now than you did. I feel more confident if you have your glasses on that you could do a better referee job if you had your glasses on, all right?
I appreciate you.
Pretty much just wrapping up the amateur career. When COVID hit, COVID pretty much was a make it or break it time. That was crazy. That was a crazy time. Luckily, the boys had illustrious boxing careers, so, you know, it was time to, like, what we gonna do? It's no sense of here fighting for free no more. It's time to make some money, like, let's go pro.
Bryce, he seems to be in total control.
This is right there, bro. You don't have to do overexert nothing. Take your time, relax.
From Fort Lauderdale, Florida, the undefeated Bobby Henry.
This is the BKFC debut for Bryce Henry. Knockdown number two.
Let's see what happened here. This is the last round. This is the champion round.
And still undefeated, Bobby Henry.
Was a professional wrestler, so oh, that's a left hook. Down goes downhill. And this one is over. Bryce Henry with a fourth round knockout over Juan Downhill.
I got two of the best fighters, hands down here in South Florida. Two of the best. And you know how hard it is for them to get a shot? I'm doing this now to make them get a shot. This is what I'm doing this for. My passion behind this. Now I got to do this. Because ain't nobody here giving us shit. I got to go out of here and be the Floyd Mayweather senior. I got to go out here and be the damn ass. Just so they can get, you know what I mean, looked at. My boys get overshadowed by a motherfucker because they got 5 million followers. Or they got 5 million followers. Oh, what you trying to get a piece of a dollar off each one of them 5 million followers? That's what it is. So we is don't have that, but we have the talent. And there's so much talent that's out here, but it's overshadowed by people who have 2 million, 5 million followers. You know what I mean? That's what I don't like. But like I said before, down the line, will that make a difference? One thing people don't know is these boxers have lives, and they have shelf lives. Just like this store on these, just like stuff in the stores on these shelves, it all has shelf lives. That means you can only have it up there for so amount of time. Why you think the average NFL running back only has X amount of years opposed to a person that plays free safety or a quarterback who's not using that much on their ligaments and joints? You got these boxers who are 23 years getting concussions and getting severely hurt. They don't have 15, 25 years. They have to get it in then. They have to get the millions in that amount of time. And by then, are they talking right? Are they, you know, everybody doesn't have that Barry Sanders mentality. You know what I'm saying? To leave early while I'm still good. Everybody doesn't have that. You got people that are still trying to do it and can't talk. They want to curt themselves. Mind's not right. Like it's, people don't realize that. But, you know, as long as, I guess they're getting paid, it don't matter. That's what I don't like.
Oh, Cinnamon, where you gonna run to? Cinnamon,
you getting this out, right?
Where you gonna run to?
Oh, God, but you know what, man? Fuck that way up.
This is definitely a star athlete, so I've never had any concern with Bryce in the fight. I really think Bryce is just needs more opportunity, more exposure. to really showcase his skills because he's probably the most talented fighter I've ever seen.
Okay, I'm tired. I'm gonna everybody up. Boxing, bare knuckle. I ain't quite MMA though, good. But going there with skills and and do what you do, have fun, you'll be fine, bro.
Young boy?
Oh God, bitch.
Early for that shit, you got right?
Huh?
Early for that shit. Yeah, I'm out of the demon time, nigga.
So I ran to the river. It was bleeding around to the sea.
Bryce is good, bro. He's looking good. He's got the range. He's got good game plan. He's got a good team behind him. He's definitely ready mentally and physically for anybody they give him.
So I ran to the river. It was boiling around to the sea. It was boiling.
Ugly son of a bitch.
Yeah, whatever.
Oh yeah, you took him out.
Yay!
No, it's light.
I'll take it, man.
We been prepping for this fight since last year. And we didn't know we were gonna have this fight, but we knew we were gonna have to take a tight fight, a tough fight soon. So we've been training every day for whatever comes our way. And it doesn't matter who it is, we're gonna kick their ass.
Big head ass nigga.
Will Smith lean in.
You laugh? That shit ain't white no more, cuz. Come here. Turn around, man.
So, Bryce.
Yeah.
Are you nervous? Are you scared? Like, how you feel about this fight?
I don't like that question, because, like, a lot of fighters, they be nervous and shit. I feel like they're nervous because they go in there and think a lot. I go in there, I know what I'm going to do. Like, I don't go in there nervous because I know my skills. I know what I do best. And this is fighting. I've been doing this for a long time, since I was 10 years old. I feel like this is natural for me. I don't gotta go in there and think like most people do. I just go in there and be me. If I go in there and think, I fuck up. So I just go in there and be free. Whatever feels natural, like water, I just go in there and do me. Am I nervous? No.
All right, Bryce, we done left the plaza, bro. We about to head to you right now. We got like a 2-hour drive, bro. Maybe a 2.5-hour drive, depending on how traffic's looking, bro. But I ain't gonna lie to you, bro. You better pull through for us, fam. Making this long-ass drive for your big-head-ass nigga.
How you feeling, Bryce?
Like, we're gonna go in there and get my bent over, you know the vibes, dude.
Bryce, we drove all the way down to Orlando to see you fight, but that's a 2-hour drive, fam. Make Jake Paul proud, bro. We drove all the way to see you fight. You better buddy up, bro. It's all or nothing, fam. Let's get it.
I'm 100% sure. Coming to kick some ass. You feel me? Could have upset somebody. Told y'all this before. We got the best in Florida. Better ask somebody.
The storm as we wait, boys. I'm telling you, this one's one where I am not blinking for a second. He's coming out and saying, I want to embarrass this.
Trying to tell you, I want that. I want it.
Beautiful right hand is Bryce. You Baba Yaga Henry.
Oh yeah.
Round 3, other nigga. What's up, nigga? That nigga Bryce hellish right now. Bacon, egg, and cheese sandwich, nigga.
Well, I run to the river. It was boiling around the river. It was boiling around.
In this sport, you can play football, you can play basketball, hell, you can even play hockey. But you cannot, and I repeat, you cannot play boxing. You'll be hurt or dead.
Ha 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 ha, you need. Don't you know I need you, Lord? Don't you know that I need you? Don't you know that I need you?
scored the bout 38-37. Judge Flutie scored the bout 38-37. And Judge LeBron scored the bout 38-37. To your winner by unanimous decision, Bryce Henry!
I just fight bubble, man. No respect, man.
Man, where do I even start? It's crazy that I started this project back in February, and it all started with some silly ass spring break boxing. Took a bunch of drunk college kids, put some gloves on, and started throwing hands at the beach. It was all fun and games until Coach Bobby seen the clips,
and he wasn't messing with it.
So we're gonna put P on some jump roping. Come over here.
So Coach Bobby took me to the boxing gym, and with the intense workout and training he had me doing, he taught me the true fundamentals to what a boxer does on a day-to-day basis.
You see, I'm trying to show you something.
And that is where I met his two sons, Trey and Bryce.
I wait for you to like push it.
Look at that nigga's neck, bro. That nigga's neck going crazy right now. Big neck ass nigga, man.
Look what the keep doing now, right? Who in their right mind gonna do that bull?
After documenting their journey, I realized that the story of the Henry brothers transcends the boundaries of sports. And what made the journey even more special was that their father was there for them. For every training session or boxing match, he was there for them to cash in his support and show love to his two sons.
Even though we was the underdog, even though we had a bunch of elements against us, we still came out victorious. I told y'all that's what we was gonna do. Hands off to our opponent. Toughest opponent thus far. Represent, bro. You did your thing, Jay. Jay Money.
I love violence, man. Like, and then why not, man? Who don't love money, man? Money, exposure.
Yeah.
A type of
exposure for him.
And who the f you know doing boxing and bare knuckle? At my age.
Ain't gonna lie?
Yes.
Oh, he got
nobody.
Hey, nobody.
Nobody.
Hey, what's
up? I'm 22, man. Nobody doing that.
We doing like you, fam?
Yeah, respect, though.
Thank you, guys.
All right, but what you gotta do, right?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey, watch out.
But just know, this is not the end of this story. This is just the beginning.
It's one thing about boxing that everyone should know. You can play football, you can play basketball, hell, you can even play hockey. But you cannot play boxing.
Don't like, don't comment, don't subscribe!
Damn.
Retake.
Don't like, don't comment, don't subscribe! Oh, damn. Oh, God, he's like killing it!
Oh,
King!
No.
Just chill.
Just chill,
Lil Wayne. I'm like, oh Lord. Yeah, I'm like, oh Lord, he getting it for real.
I got the views on that.
So
like, well, I said, yeah, I got you today. I went home, I made me one too. I'm out there like this up.
I gotta make one, bro.
I don't give a damn.
I've been be like that, just like in the room. We gotta do one in the room. We gotta be like this.
Yeah.
I don't know how to do
this
shit though,
bro. Shit, I don't know how to do that bad good either.
I be doing that bitch. In that bitch, shaking up. I seen them, they be like,
Yeah. Hey, ain't gonna lie, white man. I can't do it though. They be ripping it.
I'm going.
They be ripping it.
Go follow me on TikTok, O4L underscore Juan with a W.
Tell me.
You want to move for you? I know how some nigga like get an interview. And all that niggas around me.
Oh, you straight, bro. I ain't
right, with you. What does Bryce and Bobby mean to you?
Them boys family, like you said. Hey, family. You know, met them boys here in the gym. They been helping me get some good work in. You know what I'm saying? I fuck with them boys. It's all love. It's been what, about a good 6-7 months. Yeah, I just met them boys. But they show me love though, you know what I'm saying? It's like I've been new to these boys for a minute.
What about Coach Bobby? How you feel about
him? Oh, Coach Bobby, that's definitely fam. He come into the gym, you know what I'm saying? It's all laughs with him. Most definitely, it's all laughs with him. Every day, all day, we come in, we loud. That's my main man.
That was up, thank you.
Yeah, no problem.